So lots to talk about today. I do want to mention that, and you heard Eric talking about Ted Cruz's wife, Heidi Cruz, canceling her New Jersey trip. So I got a note last night from them, and you know, I've told you this before. So I'm one of my very good friends, Paul Teller, is Ted Cruz's chief of staff in his Senate office. And I mean, he and I go way back to when I worked in Washington, and you know, we've been in touch on and off. And of course, the Senate staff doesn't interact with you know, with the campaign, but anyway, over time, you know, staying in touch, it seems that what has happened here is, and I know the campaign has said this, she was supposed to come on tomorrow and we were all set. She was going to call at 7:08 and it was going to be a good half hour. And I get a note late last night, hey, we can't do it. And I said, well, okay, but you were calling. Like, I understand that you canceled the trip to New Jersey, but you could actually call from Wisconsin. That would be okay. Eric, how do you think that went over?
I'm guessing they didn't see the logic in your statement.
They did not see the logic. Sure. I said, you know, a phone call is a phone call, right? There are phones in Wisconsin, definitely. I'm pretty sure.
Well,
I mean, it's not New Jersey, yeah, but, you know.
They may be party lines, but.
Right. Well, it's possible. Yes. Well, you never know. Looking at some of the reports, was there any more information that was given to the press that that you saw?
No, and a lot of it was actually coming from Steve Lonergan.
Yeah,
you know, trying to say this was not a cancellation. This was a postponement. That she will be back here. But you know, there's no timing. I mean, look, I mean, the primary state that they are campaigning in right now is a very important state right now for Ted Cruz.
Yeah.
Although New Jersey may actually be the one, well, if you think about it, that could clinch the deal.
Yes, this could actually be the state that either prevents Trump from getting that 1237,
yes,
or puts him closer to saying, hey, he can go over the top.
Right, because this is also a winner-take-all state.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, it's interesting. You know, the timing of it, there are no coincidences in politics.
No, there are not.
And you know, you can say whatever you want and you can, you know, you can trash the source of, the story. But this was not something that the Cruz campaign needed.
No.
And I think, you know, although Heidi Cruz is very well spoken and,
yeah,
you know, she handles herself well in public events, I don't think the campaign wanted her out there alone at multiple events in New Jersey.
Yeah,
dealing with the New York, New Jersey, Philly media, right, asking her questions about a National Enquirer story.
I think you're right. And I was honest with them about what I was going to talk about. I was going to ask two questions. One, my question is, why did Ted Cruz not absolutely denounce, forgetting the legal idea that the super PACs are separate, but this whole idea that the super PAC out in Utah trashed Trump's wife? And that started this whole ball rolling. And I think that they made a huge mistake not coming out and saying, this is ridiculous. Wives have no place in this battle. And you know, 'cause they're not running. And then on the other side, you know, does it actually matter? So I'm going to ask you this question. Does it matter? Does it impact your vote if a candidate is unfaithful to their spouse? Do you care? I mean, it didn't matter for Bill Clinton. Certainly hasn't impacted Donald Trump's numbers. Why does it matter for Ted Cruz?